第17回日本語の文法のクラス JLPT N3 こんにちは、スー先生です。皆さんお元気ですか？今日は日本語文法の第17回のクラスです。 Today we are going to study all the grammar related to you. Since JLPT N3 has four rules related to you, as I always say, if you study related grammars at once, it helps to understand the grammar meaning and rules quickly and memorize it. Please take the class until the end today. Number one, ような気がする meaning is have a feeling that, think that. Formation is verb casual form plus ような気がする noun plus のような気がする e adjective plus ような気がするな adjective plus な気がする。 This expression is most widely used as a method of expressing premonition, prediction, and uncertain memory. This is used to express a subjective option. There are similar expressions like ような感じがする、ようと思う、ように感じる。 Then, let's make example sentences together and find out how this grammar is used in sentences.I feel like it will rain tomorrow. 明日は雨が降るような気がします。 I eat a lot every day and don't exercise, so I feel like I'm gaining weight. 毎日ご飯をいっぱい食べて運動はしないから太っているような気がします。 Oh, I have to go home. I feel like I didn't lock my house. あ、家に戻らないとダメです。家の鍵をかけなかったような気がします。I felt that the new manager was kind. 新しい部長は優しいような気がしました。It's the same expression, but if you use な adjective 親切 you can say them without よ。新しい部長は親切な気がしました。Number two, ように。Meaning is in order to, so that, hoping or wishing for something.The formation is verb dictionary form plus ように, verb ない form plus ように. This expression represents the purpose of an action. ように is often attached to a verb that expresses a state. For example, I opened the window wide so that the wind could enter the room.
風が入るように窓を大きく開けました。
I'm living in a new apartment, being careful not to get it dirty.
新しいアパートが汚れないように気をつけながら生活しています。
Number three, 用途する。Meaning is try to, be about to, attempt to. The formation is verb volition form plus とする。This must be used in combination with verb volitional form. There are two ways to use this expression. One is an expression that expresses that you are in the state just before you start doing something. The second is an expression that expresses the effort to do something. So, shall we practice this expression while making example sentences?When I was about to go home, my mother sent me a text.
家に帰ろうとしたら、母からテキストが来ました。
When I tried to sleep yesterday, my friend called me and I couldn't sleep yesterday.
昨日寝ようとしたら、友達から電話がかかってきて寝れませんでした。
Now I'm studying Japanese trying to take the JLPT N3 test.
今、私は JLPT N3 のテストを受けようとして日本語を勉強しています。
Number 4. 用途しない。The meaning is to not try to not try to make an effort to. The formation is a verb volitional form plus to しない. This grammar also must be used in combination with verb volitional form. This phrase is used to indicate that you do nothing for a long time that you intended to do or do.
用途もしない。
Is a more emphasized way to saying it. It means that there is no way to do anything at all.
営業としない means
the speaker expected to do A But he doesn't seem to do A at all. Shall we practice this expression while making example sentences too? I'm troubled. My daughter won't eat anything just because she is on a diet from this morning.
困りました。今日朝から娘がダイエットするからと言って何も食べようとしないです。
I introduced my girlfriend to my parents the other day, and then she seems to be feeling bad, and she doesn't even say the reason.
先日彼女を私の親に紹介しましたが、その後彼女の気分が悪そうなのに、その理由を言おうともしないです。
My college friend came to my place last week, but he doesn't want to go back home. What should I do?
先週、大学時代の友達が家に遊びに来ましたが、自分の家へ帰ろうとしないです。どうすればいいでしょうか?
That's all for today's grammar class on YO in JLPTN3. I've summarized the grammar for the remaining level of JLPTN3. I think it will be over after 10 more classes. Let's cheer each other up until then. As always, if you leave the example sentences in the comment section, I will let you know if there's anything to correct or advise. Sue-sensei always supports your Japanese studies. Thank you for your like, subscribe, and comments. It would be my happiness and energy to make the next class.
よろしくお願いします。それではまた。今まで、スー先生でした。